I now have my temporary studio set up here in Maine, in my friend's place. They're so generous to me. I'm so thankful for them. The sun is shining today. It's streaming in the windows, and this gives me energy and inspiration. I haven't painted for a while, so my intent this morning is to paint only for myself, to try to forget all of the influences or possibilities of what I could do with this work, like a competition or something, or a show. I just want to do something for myself. I want to work into that better. It's always a challenge and an adventure. How do we find that voice? By constantly going on those adventures of discovery. I already started this little sketch today. It's something I was sipping through my photos that kind of caught my eye. I have an idea in my head, and I hope I can hold on to that. And whether this video comes out or not doesn't really matter. I wasn't going to record today, but I thought after, no, I might do it. Somebody can learn something from this. Or I can decide not to use it at all. I hope you get a chance to find that inspirational something today, and that you get to your easel and do anything. While I'm painting today, I'm going to be listening to Liz Gilbert's Big Magic. That's one of the books I find very inspirational. She has nuggets of ideas in there that just send a spark inside of me and ignite that creativity. Sometimes it's music, sometimes it's a book or a YouTube video, something that helps build that inspiration and energy. What I usually do first is get a strong charcoal drawing down. This helps me to design the composition and to become familiar with the subject. So when I move to my painting, I already have a good amount of experience with it. It also gives me ideas. And as I draw, I think, and I write those as little notes down on the side of the paper or on a sticky note or something nearby to keep on hand when I move into the painting. Just a close-up so you can see some of my notes. Setting that aside, I get ready to start the painting. This is on a repurposed UART paper. I took the old painting, brushed most of the pastel off, and then washed it in with isopropyl alcohol. It gives a pretty good surface and an irregular underpainting to build on. I very carefully lay out the composition, the angles of the building, because that's where the most of this design comes from. To me, it's the structure and the interest of what I will be painting. I have tried this image a couple times before. As I mentioned, it's from Cadiz, Portugal. I love how the white stone and stucco bounces light around back and forth between the different surfaces. And then that brilliant cobalt sky peeking through has such a strong design. The walkway between the buildings, which is only big enough for a little cart as it's an old town, draws the viewer deeply into the distance of this painting and invites us to go far back beyond that final corner that we can see from here. This is my overall easel, the sketch, the photo, and what I'm working on for the painting.
I am mostly looking at the photo for a few details and the strength of the values. I keep stepping back and considering, looking, and thinking, what am I going to do next? I want to make strong decisions with this. Of course, one of the strongest design elements is that cobalt sky. I'm going to lay it lightly at first, and then come back and add richer color into it. There's a stony effect already evident in the stone of the building. And using the texture of the paper as my pastel skims across the top of it adds more texture. That's kind of what that stucco and stone does. The texture and the light bouncing around. Cool and warm. Working together. I'm not copying the photo. I am interpreting it to the way I would like to see it. In and out, back and forth, I keep switching up colors, the value, the very slight value change, adding texture. It's like sculpture almost, building one layer upon another. Trying to hold on to those strong geometric designs that I laid out in the beginning. I consider the lost and found edges of areas. Where do some corners blend into the stone beside it? And where do I want those strong, sharp edges that are clear? That line coming down the walkway can be very strong, so I try to soften it, push it back.
This is not exciting.
Taking
this
a step back, examining where I am,
nothing going
deciding
on here.
What's next.
Look at the same color.
Here it is about midway. Now I can move in and work a little bit more with details and finishing touches. Well, not finishing touches, but continuing touches. As I rewatch this now, I feel like I've worked too tightly in too many details, and at this point, I keep wanting to keep it looser, and because I'm not totally comfortable with this subject or this image, something out of the norm for me, because of that discomfort, I find myself picking at it. Sometimes when I struggle, I will go and search for another image of maybe a master or someone else that can help inspire me. Surprisingly, I found this John Singer Sargent that was so similar to my subject, it fascinated me. I love his color, his design, and his strokes. I want to aim more toward that. However, at this point, I think I'm a little beyond having his painting influenced mine quite a bit. Mine's gone quite a ways along, and trying to make those adjustments now, it's just building too much pastel on pastel on pastel. I may have to do this one again. I try to add some few finishing details, but I'm seeing objectively this painting has not gone where I was hoping it would. It's okay. I mean, I add in some wires to try to pull some of the elements together, and that is an interesting part to the painting. But I think it's time to get off this easel and on to the next. The important thing is to just stay dusty and keep being creative.